Hello everyone, welcome to TalentSprint, and I hope all of you are doing well and preparing well for your exam. And today we are here to discuss the last week of October current affairs. And before that, I would like to congratulate those who have cleared IBPS PO prelims exam. And in another 15 days, you'll be having mains exam. So this is the right time and very high time you should start preparing for your current affairs and general honors, right? And those who have not qualified, start preparing for the IBPS clerk. Do not stop your preparation. So let's start with the question part today. So the first question here, who has been appointed as the policy advisor in the External Affairs Minister in the rank of Additional Secretary? And the answer here is, it's Ashok Malik. Now the next question, who appointed as the new CEO of the Unique Identification Authority of India, that is UIDAI? And the answer here is, it's Pankaj Kumar. And he is currently serving as the Additional Secretary in the Ministry of Electronics and IT. And what does this Unique Identification Authority of India does? This is a statutory authority body established under the provisions of Aadhaar 2016 by the Government of India under the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. And the main aim of this body is to issue the identification authority numbers, that is Aadhaar card. And where is the headquarter of Unique Identification Authority of India? This is located in New Delhi. Now the next question, who elected as the next ambassador of India to Republic of Cabo Verde? And the answer here is, it's Godavathi Venkat Srinivas. This Cabo Verde is also known as Cap Verde. And what is the capital of Cap Verde? This is Prai, is the capital of Cap Verde. And currency is Cap Verdean Escudo. This is the currency of Cap Verde. Here, Godavathi Venkat Srinivasan, he is serving as the ambassador of India to Republic of Senegal, and he will be succeeding Rajiv Kumar. Now, the next question, who has been appointed as the 39th president of Board of Control for Cricket in India? And the answer here is, it's Sourav Ganguly. And apart from him, some new appointments also came. The Union Minister, that is Amit Shah's son Jay Shah, he has been appointed as the Secretary of BCCI. Whereas Mahim Verma has been appointed as the Vice President of BCCI. And where is the headquarter of BCCI located? This is located in Mumbai. Now the next question, the first India-Bangladesh stakeholders meet was held in Dallas, presented by Bangladesh Commerce Minister Tipu Munshi. And the answer here is, this was held in Assam. What's the capital of Assam? It's Dispur. And this meeting was held in the Guwahati of Assam. And India is the second largest trading partner of Bangladesh. And what is the capital of Bangladesh? It's Dhaka, currency is Taka, and Prime Minister is Sheikh Hasina. Now the next question, who among the following has been elected as an honorary life member of the Marylebone Cricket Club? And the answer here is, it's Lasith Malinga. He belongs to which country? He belongs to Sri Lanka. And just try to recollect, what is the capitals of Sri Lanka and who is the Prime Minister and President? Now the next question, which team won the 7th season of Vivo Pro Kabaddi League 2019? And the answer here is, this has been won by Bengal Warriors. And this is the first time Bengal Warriors has acquired this title, defeating Dabang Delhi. Now the next question, the Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India has imposed a penalty of Das on Cholamandalam MSGIC for violation of norms and conditions. And the answer here is, it's 1.01 crore penalty. And this penalty has been imposed for two factors. One is for violating the health insurance, and for that they have paid 1 crore. Whereas for violating the motor insurance, that for that they have paid 1 lakh. And where is the headquarter of Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India? This is located in Hyderabad. And who is the chairperson of IRDA? It's Subhash Chandra Khuntia. He is the chairperson of Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority. Now the next question. Mohan Bagan Athletic Club has conferred light membership to DAS. And the answer here is, this has been conferred to Abhijit Banerjee. And this Mohan Bagan Club was established in the year 1889. And who is the president of this club? It's Mr. Geeta Nath Ganguly. Now we'll move to the next question. The Indian Army is to conduct the exercise code named Sindhu Sudarshan for the year 2019 in DAS from November 29 to December 4th of 2019. And the answer here is, it's Rajasthan. So this code exercise was held in the desert of Rajasthan. And what is the aim of this exercise? This is to evaluate the capability of the defense services in an integrated air-land battle. And who is the chief of air staff? Is Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria, whereas the Chief of Army Staff is Bipin Singh Rawat. Now the next question, who became the first Indian man to win a gold medal at the Wushu World Championship held in Shanghai? And the answer here is, it's Praveen Kumar. And what is the capital of China? It's Beijing, and currency is Renminbi. Now the next question, the United Nations observe World Development Information Day on DAS every year. And the answer here is, it's on 24th of October. Next question, the United Nations Day has been celebrated on DAS, and this is also celebrated on 24th of October. Were named as the ambassador for Bharat Ki Lakshmi, an initiative by Prime Minister to celebrate the contribution and accomplishment of women in the nation for the public good. And the answer here is, it's both Deepika Padukone and PV Sindhu. So the option will be both 1 and 3. Now the next question here, the European Parliament has awarded the Sakharov Prize to DAS for his attempts to foster dialogue between Chinese people and the Uyghur. And the answer here is, it's Ilam Toti. So Uyghur are the Turkic people of northwestern China, and they have been recognized as a native to only their region. So he is the person who was trying to place a good rapport between the Chinese people and Uyghur. Now the next question, what is India's rank in the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business ranking? And the answer here is, it's 63. So India jumped to 14th place and has been ranked 63rd position among 190 countries, whereas New Zealand has stood at first position. And Somalia has stood at the last position, that is in 190th position. Now the next question. The Ministry of Health and Family Welfare will observe the Vigilance Awareness Week from 28th October to 2nd November 2019. What is the theme of it? And the answer here is, the theme of this Vigilance Awareness Week is Integrity, a Way of Life. Now the next question, the Government of India, the Government of DAS and the World Bank has signed a $165 million loan agreement for integrated irrigation project for climate resilience agriculture. And the answer here is, this has been done by Odisha. So what's the capital of Odisha? It's Bhubaneswar. Who is the Chief Minister? It's Navin Patnaik, and Governor is Ganeshi Lal. Now the next question, who become the world's richest person? And the answer here is, it's none other than Bill Gates. He is the co-founder of Microsoft, who is currently having a worth of $105.7 billion. And he has overtook Jeff Bezos, who used to become the world's richest person. And Jeff Bezos lost the title to Bill Gates after losing a $7 billion. Now the next question, who won the Wisden India Amal Naik Cricketer of the Year award? And the answer here is, this has been won by Jasprit Bumrah. So he is the Indian first bowler and batsman Smriti Mandhana won the Wisden India Amalna Cricketer of the Year award for the women. Now the next question. One of the largest biotechnology stakeholders integration program will be held for the first time in India in DAS from 21st to 23rd November of 2019. And the answer here is this is going to be held in New Delhi. So India is hosting this mega event for the biotech community to attract the investment and to showcase our indigenous strengths. Now the next question, which team has won the 2019-20 Vijay Hazare Trophy defeating Tamil Nadu at Bangalore? And the answer here is, this has been won by Karnataka. Now the next question, who won the gold in World Div Tennis Championship? And the answer here is Prithvi Sekhar. This is the second edition of World Div Tennis Championship 2019. This was held in Turkey. Now the next question. World Day for Audiovisual Heritage is celebrated all over the world on DAS and it is celebrated all over the world on 27th of October. And this year the theme of the World Day of Audiovisual Heritage is Engage the Past Through Sound and Images. And this was the theme of this year. Now the next question. The Central Board of Secondary Education and National Council for Educational Research and Training has launched an online aptitude test called Tamanna. What does N stands for in Tamanna? And the answer here is, this stands for natural. So Tamanna stands for try and measure aptitude and natural abilities. This is the full form of Tamanna. Now the next question. Which state government has inked a letter of understanding on drink from the tap mission with the United Nations Children's Fund? And the answer here is, it's Odisha. Now the next question here, the Reserve Bank of India has imposed a penalty of 35 lakhs on DAS for violating the norms on fraud classification and notification. And the answer here is, it's Tamil Nadu Percentile Bank. Now the next question, who has been appointed as the next ambassador of India to Republic of Iraq? And the answer here is, it's Birendra Singh Yadav. And he is going to replace Pradeep Singh Rajpurohit. And who is the president of Iraq? It's Barma Salil. And prime minister is Adil Abdul Mahdi. And what's the capital of Iraq? It's Baghdad. And currency is Iraqi dinar. Now the next question. Who has appointed as the 47th Chief Justice of India after the resignation of Rajan Gogoi? And the answer here is, it's Sarath Arvind Bodbe. Now the next question, who has been appointed as the Lieutenant Governor of Jammu and Kashmir? And the answer here is, it's Girish Chandra Murmu. Next question, who has been appointed as the Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh? And the answer is Radha Krishna Mathur. So earlier Satyapal Malik was the governor of Jammu and Kashmir and he has been transferred and appointed as the governor of Goa, succeeding Mridula Sinha. Now the next question, who has been appointed as the governor of Mizoram? And the answer here is P.S. Sridharan Pillai. He has been appointed as the governor of Mizoram. And he has succeeded Jagdish Mukhi. Now the next question, who is the governor of Goa? And just now we discussed Satyapal Malik, who was the governor of Jammu and Kashmir. He has been transferred to Goa, right? Now the next question. The best performing CEOs in the world 2019 list compiled by the Harvard Business Review features 100 CEOs topped by DAS. And this has been topped by Jensheng Huang. And among the top 10 executives on the list, 3 spots has been occupied by Indian origin CEO. And the first one is Adobe CEO Shantanu Narayan. He is the CEO of Adobe. He has ranked 6th, whereas MasterCard CEO Ajay Banga, he has occupied 7th position, and Microsoft CEO Satya Nadella, he has occupied 9th position. Now the next question, who owned the Mexico Grand Prix 2019? And the answer here is, this has been owned by Lewis Hamilton. Now the next question here, which state has enacted Agricultural Produce and Livestock Contract Farming and Services Act 2019? And the answer here is, this has been enacted by Tamil Nadu. And Tamil Nadu became the first state in the country to enact this law. And who is the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu? It's E.K. Palaniswamy. Governor is Banwarilal Purohit. And what's the capital of Tamil Nadu? It's Chennai. Now the next question here, who among the following has resigned recently from the portfolio amid anti-government protest? And the answer here is, it's Saad Hariri. Now the next question, who has been elected as the new Director General of International Atomic Energy Agency? And the answer here is, it's Rafael Mariano Grossi. And with this question, we have come to the end of the session. We covered all the important bits from the last week of October. We'll meet next week with the monthly current affairs from the month of October. Keep practicing, stay tuned, and all the best for your preparation.